Hey, Marvelous Small Pidgey out here. Today, I thought I would pair my rant slash opinion about Endgame with a little speed paint I did of the three topics I will be addressing. Disclaimer, this is just my opinion. Anyway, first up here, we have the points of Gamora's situation. Now, Gamora, if you don't know for some reason, was killed off in Infinity War, and she was not snapped back like everyone else. Instead, she came to the future along with Thanos and old Nebula to, like, sabotage the Avengers plan and all that. So she has no character development, no recollection, no, like, memories of the past two Guardians movies or Infinity War. I actually like this because it's an interesting plot twist. I was not expecting that to be like the main thing that they were gonna try to fix in Guardians 3. But it's a problem, especially for Peter, because they had this unspoken thing, quite literally, for most of their relationship until Infinity War. It finally happened. They finally confessed to each other. It's kind of sad because that was like before they died, but like they confessed to each other, man. And now she just doesn't have that memory. Even though she's still like a good person, she just doesn't have that memory. And it's really weird to have like Nebula farther along. Another thing that I'm looking forward to in Guardians 3 is Thor. Now, I don't think I've mentioned this on this channel yet, but Thor Ragnarok is my favorite Marvel movie. One of the reasons being, it just fixed so many things that were so wrong about, it just like got rid of all the extra boring stuff with the Thor series. Like, Taika Waititi, he pulled off some magic, I swear to God. And one of the things he did was made Thor actually more than a 2D character. He actually got some character in Ragnarok, and he remained of that character a little bit in Infinity War, and boy, did the Russo brothers add character to him in Endgame. Like, Jesus Christ. I was wondering why the fuck he wasn't depressed yet, and why, what kind of person goes through literally all of that and doesn't get sad, but then it finally happened, and it was just like, wow. It's kind of like Peter B. Parker and Into the Spider-Verse. It's like, that hit me a little bit too hard, but I ain't mad. It sucked because that was the last, like, movie in the Thor series, but now that he went with the Guardians at the end of Endgame, hopefully we will see more of him in Guardians 3 in his dynamic with everyone, and especially Star-Lord, which I love their relationship. It's hilarious. Another thing about Guardians 3, now that Thor is with them, now I'm wondering if Loki will be a part of it in some way. Because even though he was killed before the snap, just like Gamora, in Endgame, when they went back to get the Tesseract and the Mind Stone, they fucked it up. And Loki actually escaped with the Tesseract, creating a different timeline of something happening. But then they went farther back in time and, like, did that, so it all worked out. But there's still some, like, reality out there where Loki just, like, fucking escaped, man. Like, not only did he escape, like, the Avengers, but he escaped Thanos. So, maybe that's why he was so sure of himself, maybe? When he was like, the sun, don't worry, brother, the sun will shine on us again. Maybe that's why he was so sure? Did he know? I don't know how he would know. I don't know. I'm really interested to see what happens it brings up the possibility of Loki still being alive, which I like that, because it's not like a definite, like, yeah, he's back. It's more of a mystery, which really plays to Loki's character in a way. I'm so sorry that I got really sidetracked and started talking about Loki when this is clearly about Gamora. For shading the clothes, I used pen, and then when shading the skin, I used airbrush, and I did that for all three of these drawings. And I did shading and highlights for all of them.
Everything I do, the way I wear my noose, like a necklace. I wanna make them scared, like I could be anywhere, like I'm reckless. I lost my mind.
And the little question mark is like, where is Gamora? Or why is Gamora? And here we go.
I knew from the first time, I stayed for a long time, cause I like me better.
Alright, I'm gonna be honest here. The end result of this Speedpaint is shit, and I'm not proud of it. But it's fitting, because guess what? This is the only bad topic that I, or critique that I have about Endgame. like one of the only critiques I have about Endgame and the only one that I will be mentioning in this video. This one is about Steve's end. Now, if you take 2 seconds to look at my channel, you already know. You already fucking know who I ship him with, okay? And it's not to say that I don't like Peggy. I love Peggy. Like, I shipped them so hard in the first movie. But after he went into the ice and she got old and she died, I was like, it's over. And then he started, like, trying to get on with her niece. And I was like, absolutely fucking not. And so I kind of just, like, moved on. And I was not expecting them to actually, like, pull my ship off. Because they literally, the first time they ever directly acknowledged gay people was in Endgame. It was one of the Russo brothers actually played a gay character. Like, yeah, it was, like, a little, like, cheeky, like, reference in Ragnarok. Loki and the Grandmaster, and then, like, a little, like, suggestion, an emphasis for Valkyrie, but it was the first time they were actually, like, said it out loud. Like, yes, I went on a date, and this date was this of the same gender. Yeah. So, I wasn't expecting my ship to sail. No. What I am not okay with, however, is the implication that him going back in time had. Now, you could be saying, like, oh, he couldn't change anything. Well, my point is, he had to stay in the same timeline. For him to show up like that at the end to give Sam the shield, he would have to have stayed in the same timeline. Meaning that there was always two Steves this entire time. That means he went back in time and changed absolutely nothing. Because if he did change something, then it would have just made a different timeline. If you were paying fucking attention to the movie. So, don't come at me with that, oh, he couldn't change anything or mess everything up. No, it would have just made a different fucking timeline. Yay! But it's implying that he went back in time and did absolutely nothing. He did absolutely nothing. So he let Hydra literally manipulate S.H.I.E.L.D. He let Hydra kill Tony's parents. Like, before, he just knew about it. It wasn't his fault. Now, this time, it's kind of fucking his fault. He just let Hydra kill Tony's parents. He let Hydra keep torturing Bucky. And that's directly against literally every single thing that he has ever done since the beginning of his trilogy. Because, like, this is the Steve that was so fucking dumb. He went into a Hydra base alone to save his best friend. This was the person that literally just said fuck it and almost like committed suicide just because he didn't want to fight his friend in Winter Soldier. This is the dumbass Steve who went to war against half of the Avengers and all of the United Nations. And you're telling me that this is the Steve that went back in time and said, oh, everything works out in the end, so I don't have to like intervene or anything. I don't have to like maybe make his life even better. Shorten the trauma for him a little bit, because it all ends up fine. It all ends up fine, so I'll just let everything happen the way it is. No. Because Steve is a dumbass fucking bitch. Like, I love being a dumbass fucking bitch, okay? That's who he is. He's dumb. Like, oh my god. He's selfless and self-sacrificing and dumb. This is the Steve that goddamn jumped onto a fucking grenade, okay? Are you kidding me right now? Are you really saying? And then the Russo brothers in all their interviews are trying to say, like, oh yeah, we thought about that. No, you didn't. You didn't think about him being the secret husband of Peggy from The Winter Soldier, because they actually mentioned her husband. And apparently that husband was Steve the entire time if he was there. there's just a lot of like things wrong with that, but mostly just the implication that he just sat by and did nothing while the world went to shit, just under the assumption that everything would turn out fine. And that's some bullshit. Mm-hmm. And if he had changed something, it would have made a different timeline and would not have affected the world that he knew. Unless they come out and say, and no, in fact, he did use the time traveling device to get back to this timeline and deliver the shield to Sam. If they said that, I would be completely fine with that. In fact, that would fix everything. Because it wouldn't really explain how the fuck he got the Infinity Stones back, how the fuck he yeeted the Soul Storm back into Vormir. It wouldn't explain all, like, the details, but it would leave open the possibility of him actually doing something good, you know, and not suggesting the worst possibility. And then you could also keep all, like, the symbolism. Like, everyone who is, like, ever disagreed with me on this topic has always said, like, oh, what about, like, he finally got his dance. He finally got his last dance. He finally got to do something for himself. Like, he started out so selfless, and now he just did one little selfish thing for himself. And I'm like, that's great. Things coming full circle, that's my shit, man. I love that. And another symbol that people really liked was the image of an old white man passing down the torch of America to a young black man. Right. And also, this person, I will not call him out. He said that old Steve looks like Joe Biden, which I can never unsee. And it makes me laugh every single fucking time. And it makes it a little bit better. Friends, no. You know all my uncles and my aunts, though. Now I see you dress up with the socks you don't like. And I'm rolling, 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 rolling with my brothers like it's Jonas, Jonas. Drinking Henny and I'm trying to forget, but I can't get this shit out of my head. You probably think that you are better now, better now. You only say that cause I'm not around, not around. You know I never meant to let you down, let you down. Would've gave you anything, would've gave you everything. So don't take this as a, oh, angry shipper. I was never expecting my ship to sail in the first place, man. I was just salty about this very against character move that they pulled at the last minute. But, yep, that's my speed thing. Basically, it's just Steve walking away and Bucky having tears in his eyes, but not really stopping him because Bucky just wants the best for his friend, you know? And just, like, little tears in his eyes. And as far as the background color scheme, it was not my purpose to kind of make it, like, the bi-flat colors. But it happened, so happy Pride Month, guys. You know I never meant to let you down. Would've gave you anything. Alright, for my last and my favorite point in this video, and in probably all of the MCU to be honest, was Iron Man's ending, man. That shit was motherfucking beautiful. Like, the entire ending battle was so fucking good. Thank you. oh my gosh, when Peter Parker swung through that portal with his like little smile and he went up to Tony and was like saying like, oh yeah, I must have passed out, and then Doctor Strange started doing his fake thing and said like, it's been 5 years, and he goes, that's when I started crying. I cannot cry in front of people when I'm sad. When I'm happy, however, I cannot hold the tears in. If I am that happy to cry, then I cannot hold the tears in. Because it's very, this might sound like really morbid, but it is very rare that I am that happy. So when I am that happy, the tears just flow. I was just so fucking happy. I was happy when Tony got his hug from Peter. And by that time, everyone in my theater was like standing up, clapping, cheering, like, woo, yeah. I didn't start getting up and cheering until I saw Pepper come through that portal with her suit. I was like, fuck yes. Because, like, I kind of knew it was coming because they brought up the helmet earlier in the movie with Morgan and stuff. But when she finally came through, and then she fucking used it like a boss. Shots fired. And then it coming full circle with the I am inevitable. And he's like, and I am Iron Man. As soon as it panned over to Tony and he said, and I knew exactly what he was gonna say. I was like, fuck yeah. I said it with him in the theaters too. It's like we're doing fitness. His ending was so perfect. It's just another reason why I'm so salty about Steve's ending, because it was the Russo brothers. And they started out with Cap's movies. So if anything, they should have got Cap's ending perfect. But I'm glad they at least got Tony's ending perfect. It came full circle. He started out as like this selfish guy that just did stuff with for his own gain. He didn't really care about others. Kind of like how his father was saying in Endgame when he went back in time and had a conversation with his dad by accident. He was like, I wanted it to be a girl because it's less likely to be like me, all selfish and stuff. And yeah, he did start out that way. He did start out like his father in that way. But he was so selfless at the end. No, I ain't too flawless, and no, I ain't the best, and no, I don't say sorry, and no, I ain't perfect, but I am the man. I am the man. Shots fired. It wasn't until the first Avengers when he aimed that nuke to the Chitauri ship that he actually fucking saved the world. And then he got like really bad PTSD and anxiety from that. And then he does it. He self-sacrificed himself again. He knew there was no other way around it. He just did it. Hulk was able to survive it. Literally anyone else could have done it, but he did it because he knew he had to do it right then and there. They couldn't waste any more time because they came this close to losing again. And he was not going to take that chance. And I just thought it was like so fucking beautiful, honestly. This speed paint was fucking hard to draw because how the fuck? I had to look up a picture of Mark 85, which is the version that was used in Endgame. And try to mimic it in some way. I'm really proud of how it turned out. Of the fall, you feel like a bad boy while I'm King Kong. I like my little labels for my layers. Just like, color bitch. Like, I was so into this shit. I figured out how people snapped because at first I was having his thumb touch his index finger, then I was like, wait, that's not how people fucking snap, you fucking idiot. And then, like, the airbrush for the glowy stuff. I was real excited about this. I might have overdone the glowy shit, or I might have underdone it. I don't fucking care. I don't fucking know. As you see, I left the face for last because I was just so fucking hyped up. I wanted to do this scene justice. Like, I know he didn't have his hand out in the movie when he said, "I am Iron Man," but I just thought that with literally the symbol that made him who he is, like, that is the pose that Robert Downey Jr. strikes every single goddamn time. So, like, that timeless motif right there, along with what ended him, I feel like was a really good match. The only real critique that I have about this one, other than, like, the face being rushed and shit, was the arm, and my sister agreed with me. I noticed the arm was a little wonky, noticeably, like, where the elbow area is, but I didn't feel like going back fixing it, so fuck you. I tried to add some bruises and stuff, like, he had at the end. I used airbrush on the armor because it's metal, but for all the other speed paints, like I said, I used ink for the shading instead of airbrush. And then this is just a little clip of me trying to figure out what the fuck to do for the background. At first I tried to, like, imitate the ending of Endgame and it looked fucking ugly. So I was trying different, like, dark colors to contrast, like, the bright glowy colors that he was emanating. And then eventually I start experimenting with FireAlpaca's different patterns and different pin patterns. And I found some really cool fucking patterns, and I settled on this polka dot one. And then perfectly, this I am Iron Man at the end. And, yep. That's it. Hope y'all liked it. Let me know in the comments what was your favorite part of Endgame and least favorite part of Endgame, if you want to share. This is just my opinion, so don't take this too seriously. I had a lot of fun doing this.